still need an aspirin or two after yesterday's 11 miles of misery on I-4. A wrecked 18-wheeler leaning on palm trees on an embankment in Altamont Springs had all but one lane of the interstate closed eastbound for nearly 6 hours Tuesday afternoon. Even after the wreck was cleared, a traffic mess lingered.
Yeah, it clogged up those side roads and backed up interstate traffic for miles. West 2's Dave McDaniel live along the interstate during a much calmer afternoon today. But will that calm last? Dave, how's it looking right now?
Well, it's looking right now okay between Lee Road and Maitland Boulevard, though we are seeing some bunching up from time to time. But we want to go to our DOT camera up at the scene in Altamont Springs where this occurred yesterday. And we can see there are quite a few backups, visual delays, because there are work crews there on the side of the road trying to fix the damaged guardrail from yesterday's incident. We're told those work crews have been on site all day, and they thought they'd be done before rush hour started, but they've had to replace over 500 feet of guardrail, posts, and asphalt in that area, so it's taken longer than they expected. They will be on scene all the way through rush hour. They're not going to have to close any lanes of traffic, but clearly those workers being there is going to cause a visual delay. The DOT says they hope to have it 90% completed before those folks knock off at the end of their shift with some overtime included at the end of the night. Then they'll be back out there after rush hour in the morning. As for yesterday's incident, that mess, everybody we talk to say it simply takes time to clean it up.
Eastbound traffic backed up from Altamont Springs all the way through downtown Orlando.
It's a nightmare.
Drivers were more than a little frustrated.
An hour probably take me 2.5 hours.
We moved very swiftly on it.
We tracked down the man in charge of the emergency response. He knows how frustrated drivers were, but points out the truck was off the road on an embankment, leaning on trees and leaking fuel, and threatening Cranes Roost Lake.
Our main goal is to get the roads open as soon as we can, but we have to do it in a safe manner.
Those workers need space to do their jobs.
There was really no other way to do this. If we tried to rush it and do it unsafely, probably would have extended it.
It looks easy to move this right off of the embankment. It's not.
State troopers say the out-of-state driver who appeared to drift gently off the road and over the guardrail will be ticketed, more than likely for careless driving. It appears he fell asleep. As for the delay in getting I-4 back open,
we expected to be out of there right at the beginning of rush hour, and just unfortunately it took longer than that. Our goal is to keep as many lanes open as possible on our interstate systems.
She says drivers should have other ways home in their head long before they ever need them.
And to that end, Sergeant Montez says it's always a good idea to call 511, the information line, on your cell phone, either before you leave home or as you're leaving your office. That way you know whether or not you have a traffic jam ahead, so maybe you can steer around it before you get caught. Reporting live along I-4 in Orange County, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.